What's up, y'all? My name is Devontae, and I sacrificed my time so you don't have to. All right, now y'all feel y'all ready. I know y'all ready. It's the first review for Dynamite this year. Y'all my homies, man, give me a motherfucking hug. Give me that homie love, bro. Give me some of that thug passion love, man. Only the homies can show each other, man. Come on, man, bring it in, nigga. Yeah, that's right. Don't let go. Hold me tight. Pause. Yo, check it out, though, man. I'm just going to throw out a little bit of a prediction for y'all right now. Just going to throw out a bit. Just a small tidbit of a prediction. And y'all probably going to be like, oh, Devontae, we know you edited the video, Devontae. We know that you just, you're saying this right now, like 50 minutes into the show. I mean, y'all some hating ass niggas, bro. No, I'm not. Bro, damn, if it actually happens, I'm calling it right now. Nigga, it's 6:30 at night. I'm calling it right now. Call me a liar all you want to, all right? You can't call me a liar, because if I was a liar, then you know who your real father was, all right? I ain't lying. Sasha Banks, Mercedes Moné, calling it right now, is debuting tonight, all right? I'm calling it right fucking now. She's debuting tonight. Tonight's the night, right? Y'all too young to know that song. But nah, for sure, she's debuting tonight. She signed the contract. I'm calling it right now. Millions of dollars. Now, one may say to themselves, Devontae, you think she's going to debut tonight? You think AEW actually paid $1 million for Sasha Banks? Yes, I actually think Tony Khan's Mark ass forked up a couple of $1 million for Sasha Banks, silly little ass. Now, here's the kicker, though. You really think that Sasha Banks got that contract strictly for going out there and wrestling? No. She's getting paid under the table. And by under the table, I mean she's giving my dog Khan some of that good old sloppy top. Nah, who I'm fucking kidding? Tony Khan gay as fuck. Hell nah. He probably reject that shit. No, please, Mercedes. Your spit is making my dick melt. No, I'm allergic to pussy. Stop. Bro, I'm gonna get banned off of YouTube again if I keep this shit up, man. All right, here you go. Let's see what's on tap for tonight, man. What we got cooking for tonight for AEW, man? They're gonna give us a good show. They're gonna give us a good lineup. What the fuck we got going on tonight for AEW? Let's check it out real quick, man. We got Konosuke Takeshita and Don Callis. What? Oh, Don. Okay, Allahu Akbar. Takeshita, take a shit. It's gonna be facing Darby Allin. Mariah May taking on Queen Amanana. Who the fuck is that? Orange Cassidy taking on Dante Martin for the International Championship. Sorry Strickland versus Daniel Garcia. Christian Cage's State of the Union. An appearance from Adam Cole and Samoa Joe. It sounds like a show worth dying over. And by that, I mean doing... I can't say that either. God damn, bro. I'm going to get banned off of YouTube. No. I can't go that far. Okay, I'll tell you this much. It involves a gun. It involves a trigger. It involves my mouth. And it involves my brains going all over the wall. I'm going to be doing my best tribute of Kurt Cobain. I'll just put it to you like that. But with that being said, folks, this show looks like it's going to deliver tonight. I'm lying. We're going to get into the show. We're going to have fun. I'm lying again. Why can't I stop lying? Let's do it. Let's get it. Let's go. Let's go. Continue. Let's see. All right. Damn, bro, that promo was so predictable that it almost hurts a little tiny bit. Damn, that was boring. Not even bad in a sense as if like Adam Cole couldn't convey his point or get it across effectively. It's just that everything about this is just boring. I don't like, you got a bunch of twinks in Warlow, and it's just not fun, bro. You know, you had them playing back what happened on Sunday, and then Adam Cole comes out and his theme song is playing, and then it stops, and then like they debuted this generic ass lame ass theme song. And Adam Cole gets in the ring. And, you know, first off, they have a name for their stable. Get this shit, bro. The name of their stable is the Undisputed Kingdom. Like, how fucking lame do you have to be, bro? You take the Undisputed Era name and then you just combine it with their already stable name, the Kingdom. This is so... God damn, bro. They're so lame. This was just boring, bro. Adam Cole's in the ring and he's just like, durr, I was gonna get you before you got me. The locker room, they're gonna be thanking me. Warlow's gonna go after the world championship and then he's gonna beat somebody and then give it to me. Like, what the fuck is this? First off, can I say this also? I didn't mention this last Sunday. Like, I understand Warlow wanting to get his revenge against MJF. But, like, dude, if this is not the definition of, like, 5 steps forward and 10 steps back, like, bro, like, I don't understand your whole... Okay, help me out here. So, Warlow, the whole point, the reason why you were mad at MJF was because he screwed you, right, a couple times. He treated you like shit as an assistant, right? That was the whole point as to why you hated MJF, right, Warlow? Then why would you put yourself right back in the same situation with Adam Cole? What sense does that make? I don't understand that. So you left MJF to put yourself right back into the same situation that made you hate MJF to begin with? That just makes no fucking sense whatsoever. And he talks about MJF and he's like, you know what? He did say MJF is never going to come back, which means he's going to come back in a few months. He's just out right now resting his injuries. But he also said that he's happy that Samoa Joe won the world championship. But, you know, it's going to suck if he is still champion at the time when Warlow comes after him, because, man, he really doesn't want to beat up a friend or some lame shit like that. Then Jay White comes out and it's like, oh god, this can't get any more boring. This asshole comes out and he's just like, pip pip, cheerio, I sound British, but in reality, I'm closer to Australian. Well, in reality, I'm from New Zealand. I don't know where the hell I'm from. Just a mixing pot of fuckut. Like you said, I'm just a mixing pot of fuckut. Just a whole bag of fuckut. Like, ugh. Oh my god, he's like pissed off because he's like, oh, you know, you had a great plan and I admire your plan, but I hate being collateral for your plan. And I don't like being the guy who's being used to transition to a person, a spot, or a title, even though that's literally been my entire position since being in this company. I did it with the Tag Team Championships, I did it with MJF, and I did it with the Continental Classic, but I don't like being used that way, even though, legitimately, shoot-wise, I've been used that way, figuratively speaking, you fucking idiot. Oh, my God. Then he gets in the ring, and his twinks, his little boyfriends, the Gun Club, they start fighting up against the United Kingdom. And, of course, the United Kingdom outnumber them with Warlow. I mean, as if that means anything. You might as well get fucking Barry Horowitz at this goddamn point. I mean, fuck, what the hell is... You're just exchanging one jobber for another jobber. Killing Warlow for me. Just goddamn. Eventually, these assholes get outnumbered because, you know, it's 4-on-3 and it's Warlow. Which, by the way, he could probably just do it by himself. But AEW hates big men. So, of course, that's not going to happen. Realism just doesn't matter in this company. Eventually, what the hell are they called again? The LGBT, come out on a tower, the Alphabet Mafia, fucking the Acclaim come out and they, you know, beat the crap out of, they chase them out of the ring. The United, the United Kingdom. Oh my god, I can't even get this straight. The Undisputed Kingdom chased them out of the ring, and well, that was essentially the entire fucking program, the entire fucking intro, the entire fucking opener. Did I make that sound exciting for you guys? I didn't. Oh, okay. That's just probably because I'm projecting a lot right now. Because that's literally how I felt this entire intro. This sucked. This whole thing sucks. Everything about this sucks. Take away how predictable all this is. I mean, seriously. If anything, you just hurt the MJF character even more. Because he's like, I mean, what? Are you telling me that he's like the only dumbass who didn't see this coming? Like, are you serious right now? And then you, in turn... domino effect, you just hurt Warlow, because if MJF is so stupid that he couldn't figure this out, what does that make the guy who followed his lead the entire time just to go right back into the same position with the different guy after he left this guy for following this idiot's lead who thought the entire time that Adam Cole was his best friend? Oh, bro, just killing characters left and right, left and right. People are like, oh, Devonta, you're thinking about this way too hard. No, did that really take thinking too hard about? Are you retarded also? Did that really think? That really took a lot of brain power to try to figure all that out? Do I look like MJF to you? Huh? Do I look like an idiot to you? No, I don't, right? No, I don't, really? I don't. No. Clearly I don't, okay? And if you think I do, then you need to really stop talking to the mirror. Let's get back to this garbage-ass show. My God. Oh, God. Ah! Fuck! Dante Martin's in the ring! Why is Dante Martin in the fucking ring? Ah, fuck! Okay. Ah, getting triggered. I don't know. Okay. Getting triggered. Something happened on the show. Please, getting triggered. Bruh. This lame-ass episode. Yo, what the fuck? My dude. Oh, bro, you had a boring-ass match with Dante Martin and Orange Cassidy. Trust me, you know what kind of match they had. You know what kind of... Don't think too hard about it. They had that kind of match. Don't even think about it. If you watched an Orange Cassidy match, you know what kind of match they had. And then after the match, the return of Private Party. And the crowd goes absolutely mild. Nigga... Who in the fuck are you? Nigga, this generic ass fucking CAW looking dude comes out. He's like, I'm Mark Quinn. This is Isaiah Cassidy. We're both a tag team. We actually mattered like 5 years ago. No, wait, we didn't matter 5 years ago either. We're going to actually take on this tag team and actually take on this tag team and actually take on this tag team and actually, nigga, oh my God, bro, I don't give a fuck about you or Orange Cassidy or Darius Martin. I don't care about any of you guys, all right? Fuck. Oh, bro, and then you had this promo from Swerve Strickland pretty much hyping up his match with Daniel Garcia, which is the fucking main event. Look, I love Swerve Strickland. There's nothing against him, but Swerve versus Daniel Garcia is your main event. You would think maybe they would touch some more. I mean, for as fucking shitty as it is, at least try to do something with it. Build it up somehow. Do something with the, you know, what the fuck are the names again? I keep saying United Kingdom because that's UK. The Undisputed Kingdom. Do something with them. I mean, they're already boring as shit and predictable as fucking lame as fucking garbage as fuck. At least if you're going to fucking have them, do something with it's AEW. And then you had the audacity to do this boring-ass match with Mariah May versus fucking Alicia Fox, it looks like. I don't even know the girl's name. She's Alicia Fox. And she ends up beating her. By the way, it was a competitive match. You would think it was... I mean, if any match deserved to be a squash, it should have been this, but it wasn't. It was a match. A legitimate match that went on for way too fucking long. She beats her with a sit-out Death Valley driver, which looked whack as fuck. And she's like cutting a heel promo of Renee Patty Cake. And I'm thinking to myself, oh, okay. So this is how Mercedes Moné is going to come in. I'm just actually anticipating. I'm like, oh, okay. All right, cool. Bring her out. Let's see. We already know what time it is. Mercedes. Bruh. Fucking Deonna Purrazzo comes out. I can't help but think, even the audience had to think that Sasha Banks was coming out too. It's like Deonna came out and they gave her a respectful. It's like you ever go to comedy shows and they laugh at jokes that aren't funny, but it's like one of those respectful. It's like clapter, I think is what they call it, right? It's just a respectful thing to do, but in reality, you're not really doing your job right. That's how I feel like with the fans. They didn't really necessarily give a shit about any of this. They were party expecting Sasha Banks also, and they got Deonna fucking Purrazzo. It's like the complete opposite of fucking Raw. It's like Raw, you got The Rock, and, you know, Jinder Mahal comes out first, and you were expecting The Rock. And in this one, it's like you're expecting Sasha Banks and fucking Deonna Purrazzo. Because she cuts a shitty promo. She says nothing inspiring. She's just like, I'm from New Jersey! Yeah, bitch, where's the situation? Where's the other whores who smell like fucking orange juice that's been sitting out in the sun all day? Yeah, bitch, I'm yelling and I'm obnoxious for no reason because I'm from Jersey. I like to lick ass because I'm from Jersey. Shit, me not, bro. Oh, bro, Christian's in the ring. Let's see what he's talking about. Help me out, Christian. God almighty, help me out. Please. Please, please. Please, for the love of God, I beg. AEW. Help me. Somebody help. I don't want to go out like this. No. The torture. The torture. Ah, God, it's like I'm in Guantanamo Bay. What did I do? Oh, this is so fucking bad. I can't do this. Okay, so Takeshita had a match against Darby Allin. Bruh. I can't do this. Christian had a promo and that shit went on and on and on and nobody came out. Oh my God, this Christian promo. Oh, I'm just gonna skip over Takeshita and Darby. I can't. Oh, I'm sacrificing myself, folks. It's more than just my time. It's my body. It's my spirit. Oh my God, Christian comes out and he cuts a promo. Oh, dude, Nick Wayne's hot-ass mom gets on the microphone. Oh, she starts speaking Karenese. Real talk, though, she was so fucking over the top. Like, oh my God, bro, she looked like a method actor. I mean, this bitch is all out there making all these types of facials, and not the kind of facial that I would like to give her, but I mean these weird fucking clenching of the teeth, and you don't boo mothers. Like, what is this overacting? Bitch, you acting like you Charlie Chaplin or Rudolph Valentino if you don't take your carrot ass out somewhere. All this overacting. Holy shit. I mean, she is like straining. She looks like she's taking a shit or something, bro. Thankfully, Christian takes the microphone away from her garbage ass. And, you know, he starts to spit a little bit. I mean, I like what Christian is doing. And I like what he was attempting to do here. He's trying to build up more tension with Luchasaurus. Oh, I'm sorry, Kill Switch. But goddamn, bro, it just went on and on and on and on. And you know what? I would much prefer to see more promos than wrestling. But my God, bro. Oh my God, the Dark Callus. What are they saying? Okay, he didn't say anything. At least I didn't pay attention. All I heard was Will Hobbs and I heard Sting. I'm pretty sure they're not going to do a one-on-one match with Will Hobbs and Sting. That's got to be an angle because that'd just be fucking atrocious. Oh, bro. Eventually, Christian, though, just getting me back to what I was saying. Christian, eventually, he's like going to each person. He's like going to eventually fucking Kill Switch or Luchasaurus. And it was like, he looks like he's going to thank him because Luchasaurus gave Christian his contract in order for Christian to cash in to get that world championship or the TNT championship. And instead he thanks himself and he's like playing the whole delusional heel role, which is fine. That's Christian at his best. I mean, Christian is fine. It's good. It's just his promo went on way too long. And Nick Wayne's mom, bro, she would do great in Brazzers. She would do great in Mike in Brazil, okay? She'd be great on the hub. But get her off my television. If she ain't in a bikini, I don't want to see her anywhere near my... Just please, never again. What the fuck were you people thinking? And what is this match, bro? Oh, my God. Oh yeah, that's right. They're having a fatal four-way match. That's a shoot. They're having a fatal four-way match for the Continental Championship. Bro, I don't think I'm going to be able to make it. I gotta stay strong for you guys. I gotta keep pushing. I gotta sit up and I gotta keep pushing. But this is hard. This is tough. I think I'd rather be waterboarded. Oh, man. This is a great way to get information out of, like, an informant or something. Like, this is a great, great torture match. Oh, this is a great torture method. I can't even speak straight. That's how fucking... I'm so defeated. This show made me lose energy. I am weak. I just want to go to bed. Fuck this show. Just fuck this show. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Kill me in a video game. These motherfuckers are dancing to Swerve's theme song again. All right. That's it, folks. I'm done. All right. I'm tapping out. Swerve is about to wrestle against Daniel Garcia. I'm good, bro. This Fatal 4-Way match damn near put me to sleep. I don't know what the hell this backstage shit was with Adam Page. I don't care what happens after this match. I'm done. There's nothing that they're going to do in the end of the match that's going to get everybody talking anyways. I don't care if Adam Page gets attacked again or you fight someone backstage, if that even occurs. I'm good, bro. I'm done. This show sucked absolute dick. Not that I was... You know what? No, I'm not going to say that. I'm going to say, like, I was actually expecting the show to be somewhat good. I'm not even going to front with you. I actually was expecting the show to deliver because it's the first show of the year, bruh. And this shit is, like, this was such a disappointing show. They're back to their stupid-ass ways again of just doing match after 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 match. After match, after match, after match, after match. You get the fucking points. I don't... Bruh, okay. Did we even see Samoa Joe tonight? I don't think we did. How the fuck do you have Samoa Joe win the belt off of your form? This just... God, the booking just makes no fucking sense whatsoever, bro. And if Samoa Joe were to show up, I don't care. You don't show Samoa Joe not one time throughout the fucking night. And if he somehow shows up after the Swerve match, you think it's a good idea to show Samoa Joe at the very tail end of the show and not one time throughout the night? Does that make sense to you, AEW? Does that make sense to you, Tony Khan? But you want to sit here and try to gaslight us and tell us that that championship of yours happens to be one of the biggest priorities, not just in your company, but you have the fucking nerve, the audacity, the gall, the chutzpah, whatever that word means. You have the nerve to say that it's the most prestigious champion in all of professional wrestling. MJF said that same clown ass shit too. Dude, you couldn't even show us your world champion the night after or the pay-per-view after him winning the world championship. MJF had that belt. He's the longest reigning AEW World Heavyweight Champion. And his reign ends. And you don't show us the AEW World Champion? Well, is it going to be on fucking Collision? Is it going to be next week on Dynamite? Does that make any sense to you? Oh, boy. So we got no semblance of any of the main event players playing throughout the night. It was just show this boring-ass predictable stable with the Undisputed Kingdom. Finally got it right. You're showing them in the beginning of the show. You don't show them no more throughout the show. How do you fans do this shit, bruh? How do AEW fans do this shit? That's incredible, bro. You guys are masochists, bruh. Like, I swear to God, you guys, or is it sadists? Or it's just a sadist masochist overall. I don't know. You guys enjoy pain, though. You guys love pain. I can't, though. I don't like pain. I don't like my mind racing 35 miles per hour and there's literally no cars in the lane. That's how empty my head is right now. That's how empty my brain feels right now. I legitimately dropped my phone on the floor falling asleep. That's what woke me up. If it wasn't for that, I probably would have fell forward out of my chair, gave myself a concussion, and that would have been on you, AEW. Death of Devontae Rackley, 1992 to 2024. Death by suffering. That would have been all on you, AEW. That would have been all on you. So now you have to live with yourself, knowing that you damn near killed one of the people who were reviewing your shows in a negative way. Yeah, she probably will love that now that I'm saying it out loud like that. Oh boy, like I said, we got Swerve Strickland in the main event going up against Daniel Garcia. All the matches tonight were absolutely garbage. No Mercedes Moné, no surprises, no twists, no spins, nothing. Absolutely nothing. Just match after match after match. You know I'm not going down that path again. They gotta do better than this, man. They gotta do better than this. There's no way that you should be doing the exact same shit you did last year to put yourself into a position where no one is watching your shitty, lame-ass show because you're still constantly doing the same fucking formula. I would have hoped, I would have thought that they would have won a cup out of the shoe. Shoot yawn. Look at that shit. I would have hoped that they would have won a come out of the shoot with guns a-blazing. Instead, we got water pistols. We got some firecrackers. Hey, look, maybe that's a Roman candle, but nah, that might be a little bit too tough for the situation right now also. You gotta do better than this, Tony. This ain't gonna work, bro. This ain't it. I legitimately mean this as a concerned fan to a lesser degree. This ain't it, bro. All of what we're seeing right now, please don't do this again. Get better. Are you competing with WWE? Are you staying in your own lane? Are you just like going to concede to defeat? Because last time I checked, the countdown is officially on. Your TV contract comes up due later on this year in October. I would think personally, but maybe I'm just being too much of a big brain. I'm being a big brain person right now. You would think that you would have wanted to put on something that, you know, attracts all fans. Because I'm pretty sure somewhere in their little mountain cave, their little dwellings with their little XXX magazines lying all over the floor. Nah, they're internet dweebs. They're most likely going to have their XXX material bookmarked somewhere on their laptop. Damn, I'm projecting like a motherfucker right now. You can appeal to those people as much as you want, bruh. But the more and more and more you go down this path, the more and more and more, those are going to be the only fans around. And I would like for you to try to explain to me or anybody how you're going to sell the TBS executives, the TNT executives, Warner Brothers Discovery, and in general their executives. I would love for you to explain how the fuck you're going to try to get a new TV deal or a better TV deal when Wrestling Notaku is your entire fan base right about now. Make it make sense and do better. But with that being said, I'm going to take my black ass to bed because, you know, I deserve it because I've been having a hard day's work. And I consider AEW and reviewing their shows to be work also. So I'm going to go take my black ass to bed. With that being said, I'll be catching you guys later. Deuces, P.I.s.